Listen, we've all made questionable purchases in the past, but today I'm going to talk about four things that I regret spending money on. But before we get into that, I just want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. My name is Danielle. I do videos on personal development and growth, as well as some story time videos. And if that sounds like something that you'd like to stick around for, maybe click that subscribe button. We'd love to have you here. The first thing that I really regret spending money on is kind of a general category, which is cheap clothing, cheap shoes, cheap jewelry, cheap accessories. The theme of that is that they're cheap. So my entire adult life, I have spent working in some form of customer service, whether it was shoe retail, clothing retail, restaurant waitressing, or even being a receptionist in an office. But especially when you're working in clothing retail or shoe retail, it is incredibly difficult to resist the siren song of a deal. Not to mention the fact that you are more or less expected to come to work wearing the product that you are going to be selling. And whether they say it out loud or not, you are more or less also expected to be wearing the most current items as well. So, I amassed a lot of clothing and a lot of shoes. And to be totally honest, a lot of it was shit. Just cheap, cheap shit. And even if it wasn't cheaply made or with cheap fabrics or cheap materials, it was made in such a trendy way that I wouldn't be able to wear it long term. So now I'm at the point in my life where I'm trying to just spend on clothing and footwear a little more thoughtfully, buying more timeless pieces, a few other items that maybe I wouldn't mind wearing over and over and over again, and even thrifting a little bit for those kind of really fun pieces that I can't wear as often. The second category of things I regret spending money on are crafting supplies. Now, I'm a person that I love to make things with my hands. I recently was nominated for a show where I got to build a tiny set for tiny little puppet people. It was so much fun. I had a blast. But that is not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is buying crafting items for myself that I then don't use or take up a lot of space or get used for one project and then never get used again. I'm thinking very specifically on a very specific type of crafting supply that I bought a few years ago. I wanna say about 5-ish years ago, I got it into my head that I really wanted to make customized mugs. I would give them away as gifts, I would keep them for myself, they would have cute little like pictures on them. I really wanted to do that. So I started looking for ceramic paint. And what I found were these Martha Stewart branded ceramic glass paint, and they were not cheap, but I bought so many colors. Didn't even think that, oh, maybe I should buy a few, see how I like them. If I don't, try out a different brand. Nope, didn't think about that. Just wanted to buy them all and be done with it. Well, I didn't necessarily enjoy using them. They were not kind of what I was looking for, but I tried to make use of them anyways. And then eventually I was just kind of like, I have enough mugs. I don't want to give mugs as gifts anymore. And I just sat on these paints for years and lugged them from house to house to house as I moved. Recently, I did get rid of them. I donated them, but it was one of those things that I would just kind of look at them full of guilt, being like, I spent too much money on you and I didn't use them the way that I was hoping I would. The third category that I regret spending money on is books. Now wait, 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 wait. I'd first like to say that I am an avid reader. Most people that know me know that I'm always reading a book, or I have a book on the go, or I can make recommendations, or that a safe bet for a gift for me is a book. That being said though, there was a very specific period of time in my life where I bought a lot of books very mindlessly, and I didn't realize until afterwards how much money I was spending, but also that I was doing it because I was going through a really weird patch of depression and I didn't recognize it. I was freshly out of university. I was working two jobs over the summer. I wasn't seeing my friends. I was working multiple days in a row with no breaks. I would often go from my 9-to-5 job in an office straight to the mall where I was working in clothing retail, and I would have maybe 30 minutes in between, and where would I go? I would go to the bookstore and I would just pick up multiple books every single time I was there with no plan on when I was going to read them or if I was going to read them. And in fact, I actually didn't read a lot of those books. And so finally, I just donated them. As with everything that I'm purchasing now and bringing into my life, I'm trying to be a bit more mindful, especially with books because they are quite heavy. Last year I moved twice in a matter of 5 months, and let me tell you, moving books, heavy. So I'm kind of at the point where I'm really trying to pare down the books that I do have so that it is a collection of books that I absolutely love, that I'm happy to take with me place to place, and that bring me a lot of happiness to have. Any other books, I'm either looking to go to the library, borrow books from friends, or even ebooks so that I can just have them on a tablet. And the fourth and final category of things that I regret spending money on, this really won't come as a surprise to you if you've watched my other videos, Amway. Not only in Amway did I have to pay to start up, I had to pay for product and books and conferences. And when you're doing it, it doesn't feel like a lot, but it also really adds up. Now I just don't partake in MLMs at all. So there we are. Those are the four things that I regret spending money on the most in the past. Over time, my reason for buying things has changed. My aim for quality over quantity has really changed as well. And I would say the theme of my money spending these days is a balance of necessity as well as thoughtfulness. But that's all I have to say on that. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed it or learned something, or it made you think about your own spending habits. If you like this video, please click that like button. And if you feel like you want to stick around for more videos of my face and me talking, please click that subscribe button and maybe think about clicking that bell icon so you never miss a Monday upload. But until next time, guys, be good out there. Bye.